It was more about what they can bring to the table in the field. So that's what I've received from entrepreneurship, you understand? So I came up with an idea, even Okuhle. That's how we started those ones.
Oh,
wow. We did the same course, same class, you understand? But yeah, my question for you, guys, I hope that we keep it short.
Okay.
I wanted to ask, in fact, does the lack of role models impact how we run our life and business? If there's not a, if I say a lack and I don't say a lack, just give me maybe a scenario whereby you say, okay, I was empowered by Utabalban and then today this is where I am.
Okay, so from my side, the lack of role models actually it impacts us, in sort of a bad way, to a point that personally I had to look for role models. You see, I couldn't find them like where I was staying and stuff, especially when you're an entrepreneur and stuff. Like a lot of people are not entrepreneurs, even people are doing business in township most of the time, just for survival. It's not the type of entrepreneurship we're doing. They are doing business because maybe someone doesn't have a job. And the minute they get a job, like, they're gone. So when you want to do business, like you're an entrepreneur, it's sort of a calling. Now I had to look for those people. And you do that sort of now by reading books, trying to find people you can listen to. For me, was one of those people. But one person that actually affected me the most when I was starting business, it was Robert Kiyosaki. So he was kind of like my role model. Yeah, I've read a lot of people like, but I think Robert Kiyosaki was actually the one that sparked the thing. He validated a lot of things that was in my mind. It was again this thing of, I think he has a book like, why C students hire A students? Part that says now you don't have to go to school, you can hire someone. The lack of role models can actually impact us in the learning, right? And I believe that's what is happening sometimes in township. But people are looking up to gangsters and stuff. There are no like, since you mentioned as well that if you make it or you get money, actually you will leave the township. They are left with no role models and stuff.
Because sometimes I feel like in a way it can also slow down your process and everything, or it can just fasten the process, understand? So I feel like you need one more. It's called a mentor most in business, understand? You need a mentor, you do need a mentor. I feel like even now going to the upper right now, I feel like I do need a mentor, you understand? But I feel like I can go far with someone who can just show me the ropes. Okay, Sepan, you are doing this, I've been there before, so I can do this. You can do this way, which will get you there faster, you understand? Because right now, even we're still growing, you understand? I still want to grow, I still want to know more, you understand? That's it. I feel like, you do need one.
So my last question, guys, is that is important, is marriage important for an entrepreneur? Is it a must for you to get married as an entrepreneur to succeed? Or it's not a must?
I don't feel like it's not a must. You don't have to. And I said yes, but remember then, you need to understand. The thing is, you cannot force marriage, understand? I don't know, I'm not married, then I'll never be married. I'm not sure if I'll never be married. But the thing is, for now, my feelings are there. Never, but all I'm saying is, you can never force another. Because like you said, when you're an entrepreneur, you need someone who's going to understand why this guy is trying to build something out of nothing, you understand? In order for someone to understand, because remember, right now, what you're doing now, it doesn't mean by month end we're gonna get millions, understand? Which means in the next few to 5 years, we need someone who's gonna be patient, understand? So right now, for you to say, but do you need marriage to be successful in entrepreneurship? No, as much as you need to find discipline, understand? Because remember, the reason you need that woman in your life because you want stability. You want to promote discipline because the thing is, I feel like you're gonna use marriage as an excuse to not want to be disciplined. You understand? I feel like people need someone. It's like you need a man. You understand? Yes, don't get me wrong, sex or whatever, fuck it. Okay, the thing is, people are using it as an excuse, you understand? When they married, they start doing stupid nonsense, you understand? So for me, no, you don't need it, but you need to be more disciplined and know what you want and understand that your mother is not going to be always there with you, you understand? Because we want to make that woman your mother, you understand?
As for me, since I'm a Christian, so as God says that it's not good for a man to be alone. For me, I do believe that I need someone. And I think I need them ASAP. I'm saying that because you see, I think like most of us as entrepreneurs now, we are still at a stage where we don't have a lot of money and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
But we know that at some point we're gonna have a lot of money. So the reason I'm saying that, I think I need that person ASAP because I want them to be part of the process, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to look for a wife when I got money because, I mean, you know, when you have money, you can never know who really loves you and stuff. So for me, that's why I say ASAP. I think I need a woman and I think actually the right woman actually can make things better for you.
I have a question.
Okay, cool.
If you're looking outside now, man,
yeah.
Let's leave social media. Now. From what you're seeing, from what the world is presenting at us with these kind of women that we have, do you think there's a woman out there that will bear an advantage when as an entrepreneur in terms of what you're trying to achieve? Remember, you are trying to achieve something out of nothing. You have no financial background. You don't come from a rich family. Like they say, most of the rich family must come from you. And I said, do you think there's any woman there when they say, so let's say, right now, pops into your account. When you say, okay, take this money and put it back to the business. Do you think there's a woman out there right now would understand that?
Yeah, from my actual years.
Yeah, like I said, men of course, so your faith, yeah, most of them
can't. It's not really just about it. Yes, of course, the faith is part of it. Like, I know God, with God, there's nothing impossible.
Amen.
So, I know I can, and not only because of the faith part, you know. I've met people, man, like, that. So of course, man, there are a lot of qualities that we are looking for. I've met women that you can see as this one. But of course, since you are looking for many features, so she can be that person, but like maybe the beauty is lacking.
That's a problem.
No, I'm saying that. So like, I do believe like there are people. I've met people like the woman that I think are this one. Like,
I know. But you do understand that those kind of women, you understand? They would prefer a guy. I've seen this many of times. You see a guy treating a woman badly in terms of like, no attention, no nothing, no whatever, no nothing. But you see, this woman is actually a good woman. But when it comes to you and you show your true self, okay, I'm this kind of person.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a man of God, quote unquote.
Okay, cool.
And I want this in my life, you understand?
Mm.
But when it comes to you, you're wearing a, the same reaction you would expect from that good woman. It's not gonna be the same when it comes to you.
So we're just gonna close this off now with your two questions because it seems like you have a lot to to express. Give us some time. What are the two questions so we can close it off?
Okay. For me, ne, my question would be to you guys, ne.
Yeah.
Since we are all from here, the township, you understand?
Yeah.
Do you think even right now, let's be more realistic, man. I don't wanna be cool, whatever. Even right now, ne, looking at what your current habits right now, what you're doing right now, do you think your future self, let's say your 3 years to 4 years now, with all these actions, where would you be?
No.
No, like I'm just saying, your current habits right now. You understand?
I think my current habits, might take me somewhere, because of now I start to read. I've been a reader. I have 4 books that I'm reading as we speak.
Okay.
And I'm starting to pray nowadays. I'm starting to focus on
spirituality.
Hallelujah.
Okay.
And I'm looking for a wife, in fact. That's me. So in the future, guaranteed, in fact, I'll be elsewhere. Like, that's a guarantee. So I just need to be consistent. Yeah.
Read, pray, wife, and searching.
Yeah, I'm searching for a wife,
That makes the two of us.
I'm praying to your wife.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's for me. I believe, I might be wrong, whatever, but when I'm looking at myself, I do believe that I do have like sort of the right habits. But it's a matter of now like meeting like the opportunity. Because you know that you can be doing the right things and stuff, but if maybe you're not at the right place and stuff, because you know there are a lot of people out there who are working hard, who are good guys and stuff, but because of opportunity sometimes they don't meet actually the right opportunity or they don't get to the right places and stuff. So as for me, I think just a matter of the moment, bro. Like, well, just the opportunity coming, and I think I'm ready for the next level.
Preparation meets opportunity.
One of those things. Okay. What is my last question? Because I had this question on the top of my mind, guys. Also, guys, now, looking at the current business you guys are doing right now, do you think, like, who's someone you have seen succeed you know, kind of bitch right now. That you can say, like, that you can say, ah, man, this person has been here in my position before.
Yeah.
Now I'm sure I'm gonna make it.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen anyone ever cast? Like, because they cast in general. Let's leave all of the Kiosaki, let's use someone you know, or someone you've seen, or someone. Okay, let me just put it, bring it back. Someone from here in South Africa.
Yeah.